How you been with me so late?
Why you
bro?
Gotta do it? I'm so touched right now.
That boy is Benny Hanna.
It's a new vid.
Like it.
It's a new vid.
Subscribe.
It's a new vid.
Share.
It's a new vid.
Comment.
It's a new vid.
Like
it's
it.
New vid. It's a new vid.
Share.
It's a new vid.
Subscribe.
Hey guys, what is up? My name is Tyquan up there, and I hope you're having a wonderful day wherever you are. And this is actually a story time, right? That I've actually been holding on to for a while, dog. Today I'm gonna be telling you about my ex-toxic girl best friend, you know? So you should make sure to get some snacks, get some drinks, sit down, get comfortable, and let's just get into this story because this is a long one, alright? But I promise you, it's worth it. If you are new here and you like what you see on this channel, make sure to like, subscribe, share, and tell a friend. Make sure to turn on my post notifications so you'll be notified every single time that I, Tyquan Neblett, post a video. Like I said, my name is Tyquan Neblett, and I post videos like these story times on my channel. I also post rant videos and just normal sketches and comedy videos. So make sure to subscribe and come along for the journey, man.
This is do or die. Burning bridges, cutting ties to cross that weapon in the sky. The devil is alive.
So this all started when I was in first form, alright? When I first came to this new school, I just moved from primary school into secondary school, right? And my secondary school was far from my house, so I had to get up every day at 5 o'clock to get the bus. So now I first get into class, and as soon as I get into class, I notice these three girls. All three of them look pretty cute at the front of the class sitting together, alright? Now this was like first form, so like this is before all of us hit puberty. So we're all like 11, 12 at this time, freshly out of primary school. I started to talk to one of these girls. Out of these three girls, right, I instantly had a crush on one of them, right? We're gonna call her Jude. If I'm being honest, she kinda looked like my neighbor. I don't know, I guess that's why I had a crush on her, I don't know what it was. I won't say a friendship, but we would talk from time to time. I did have a crush on her, but I wasn't trying to talk to her like that because back in the day, I was a pretty shy and reserved kid. I wouldn't like outrightly go and talk to a girl if I liked her. I would just be friendly and then hope something happened. I never used to shoot my shot back in the day. But then I did the stupid thing that we all do when we are kids, right? So this guy that I just met in my class, right? I tell him, I think like after a few days, that I actually had a crush on Jude. And he goes and tells her. So like he took her out of the class, right? I heard over her that he told her that I liked her, and all I heard was her shout ew. That broke my heart. That broke my itty bitty 11 year old heart. I was like, you know what, it hurts, but that's okay, I'ma just be your friend. And I was cool with that, you know, like, to be honest, no one owes you a relationship, no one has to like you back in this world, so I was pretty okay with being her friend at this point. So we got into third form, right? If you're not from the Caribbean, this whole school work, you come out of primary school in class 4, and then you go into first form to sixth form, alright? After that, that's when you go to college. My school, we didn't have a sixth form at that time, so from fifth form we went straight to college. And at this time, like, everyone is going through puberty, everyone had their groups at this point in time, and I had my group of friends, and I was okay, you know, I wasn't trying to fit in, I wasn't trying to be a person that I wasn't, I was just pretty comfortable with the friends that I had, and I kind of kept a low profile, and I was totally cool with that. But at this time, Jude was a totally different person, all right like, she tried so hard to fit in that to a point I would see it and then I would get annoyed, because I don't know, it's not my place, but I literally would get annoyed seeing her try to fit in so hard. Like, she was trying to be someone that she wasn't, you know? But I was like, you know what? I guess we all gotta go through that phase or whatever, whatever. I was pretty cool with that until she started saying some stupid shit in class. And then for some weird reason, although we were like friends from first to second form, when we got into third form, for some reason, she didn't really want to speak to me. And then like, if I tried to speak to her at school, she would act like if she didn't want to talk to me. And I was like, whoa, you kind of switch up on me, my dude. Like, I thought we were cool. And I remember like we were bitter enemies in third form after that. So then we got into fourth form, right? And at this point, fourth form is like senior school, right? So like you wear a different uniform and everyone has really gone through puberty and all that stuff. Personally, not me, because I hit puberty in like fifth form, if I'm being honest. But at this time, everybody was kind of cool with everybody. And at this time, I actually became a sub-prefect. A prefect is basically a person who helps teachers take care of the lower school. So I was a sub-prefect and she was one too. And at this time, we actually started to talk more again, all right? We actually became friends once again. I was like, yo, like, we both are prefects and we probably gonna have to be around each other a lot, so it doesn't make sense me being a little bitch to you all the time. Like, at this time, and I actually recently started my YouTube channel, and she was one of the people who actually like started watching my videos. At this time, like I said, we friends again, we talking a lot, right? And then those feelings came back up, those feelings that I had bad when we were like in first form. Literally, as soon as I heard her say ew, I cut them off. But when I got back into fourth form, I was like, you know what, man? I kind of like you again, you know? So then I remember a weekend, right? I sat down and like, I wrote this whole thing, what I would tell her, what I would say. And you know, I watched videos on how to shoot your shot, how to tell a girl you like her, all that stuff, dog. I was getting prepared for war. So Monday morning, I wake up all enthusiastic. I wake up ready because I've studied. I know what the plan is. I know what I have to do. But then I get to school, right? Let me tell you what I see. I literally see Jude, right, on a bench with my best friend. And I'm like, okay, that's cool. I guess they're friends too. And then I literally see them kiss right in front of me, dog. And I'm like, when was, like, neither of them told me, right? I know I was close to Ozzy, right? This is like my best friend, you know, from like first form. I recently got close again with Jude, so I was like, yo, when did it? And then I was told that both of them were talking for like, I think 1 or 2 months, and they were basically together at this point. Tell me, what would you do? So I went to Jude. I was like, yo, Jude, I'm sorry to tell you this, right? But like, I liked you in first form, and we recently started back talking, and I actually developed feelings for you again, and I'm really sorry about that. And then I went to him, and I was like, yo, Ozzy, I know this is a really strange thing to say, right? But I actually have feelings for Jude. And like, since we recently started back talking, I developed feelings, but you didn't tell me that you were talking to her. And I'm really sorry, dog, and I hope this don't affect our friendship. And I apologize again for having feelings for her. And I told both of them, look, I am going to distance myself from both of y'all for the next few weeks, all right? I ain't gonna message y'all. I ain't gonna talk to y'all. I ain't gonna do nothing. He was hurt, but she was kind of actually ecstatic about it. Now, you would think, right, that since this is a mature thing to do, that everything was good after this, right? But no, this was the worst thing that I've ever done. Now, let me give you some context. This girl actually looked at me one day and said, yo, I am the type of girl that if I feel that my relationship is getting boring or I feel bored in a relationship, I will literally cause conflict just to have some excitement. And what do you know? She now has something that she can use to cause conflict in her relationship. And she literally used the fact that I liked her to literally cause conflict in her relationship with Ozzy. Everything that I said or did was interpreted in a way and then relayed to Ozzy in a way, right, to make it seem like if I still liked her. Although let me tell you something, right, after those 2 weeks that I distanced myself from both of them, my feelings were done. I was already trying to talk to somebody else after that. So we were in biology class, right? Me and her took biology together, and at this time she started calling me like her male best friend. Like, she was closer to me, and to me that was endearing, you know, because I was like, yo, I guess everything is better now. Like, this person that I thought would not talk to me after this, they're actually talking to me. No, we all in biology class now, right? She looks at me and she says, Tyquan, give me a hug. So this girl, right, wraps her hands around me, all innocent enough. I'm like, okay, cool, just a hug, like, we best friends. And then this girl sinks her teeth into my neck. Big man, big man, you do not do that to a now developing 16-year-old boy, okay? So then I get home and I get a message, dog, from my boy Ozzy. He is gonna message me and say, yo, I think you need to distance yourself from Jude. People in your class are telling me that y'all look too close. She's the one that asked me for a hug. Now, let me give you another example, right? So now there was this concert happening at our school. My boy Ozzy, he was performing, all right? And of course, his girlfriend at the time, Jude, had to be in the audience. Now, you gotta support your man and think. Now, I had to be there because I was actually head boy at this time, right? So I had to be at all the events, you know? So I get there, right? And during this weekend, back in the day, I was really, really into art, right? I was drawing almost every single day, right? And at this time, I remember I had a really rough weekend. And I drew this eye, like just this eye, and it had tears in it, right? And I was like, yo, I was actually impressed with myself how good this thing looked, right? I know it probably wasn't that good, but back then I was amazed with it. So I get to this concert, right? Now I dressed up and I'm looking pretty nice. I'm feeling good about myself. So I sit with Jude and a couple of her friends, right? And we strike up a conversation about my drawing and my art and stuff, because we used to post a lot of art back in the day, right? On my social media. And she literally looks at me, she's like, yo, Ty, show the girls like your art, me. So I showed them the eye that I just drew, right? And everyone was like, yo, this looks really good. Everyone complimented me on my art and things, and now I feel real good. I get home from this concert, my G, and I see a message from your boy Ozzy. Boy, get message my good up phone and say, yo, I think you need to distance yourself from Jude. She is telling me that you are still feeling a way about what has happened and that you are literally drawing your feelings for her. I didn't
like you that much for me to draw my feelings, but you, girl, my feelings are going every since. I was just trying to exist, dog, and this girl was making every single thing that I did about her. She literally turned my best friend against me, dog, and she even ruined relationships that I had too. Jude had a friend, but we're gonna call her Hinata, all right? She actually has a, she had like a pretty kind of Hinata personality. She was shy, she was sweet, she liked me. Jude told me that Hinata liked me, so I went to her, right? And I was like, yo, I heard you like me, you know, I kind of like you too. We got together on like a Friday, right? I remember I was in the art room with Jude, right, and another friend, and Jude looks at me and she's like, oh, so do you love Hinata? I was like, I said no, I like her at this point, like love is too far, like we just got together, you know, it's only been like a few days. This girl went ballistic, dog. This girl got so pissed off at me just because I wouldn't say, just because I said I liked Hinata and that I didn't love her, dog. She's like, how can you not love my best friend? Because Hinata was her best friend too. How can you not love my best friend? Like, she likes you so much. How can you not love her? And I was like, yo, dog, liking and loving is two different things. Like, Sunday morning, I wake up to 4 voice notes from Hinata, right? And she's in these voice notes crying, dog. And she says, I do not think I'm ready for this. I'm gonna have to break up for you. And I am so sorry for getting your hopes up. Now tell me, right? Doesn't that seem a bit convenient? At this point, I was kind of distance myself from her and Ozzy because both of them were starting to fucking piss me off. Like, I was trying my best to be a good friend to both of them. And for some reason, every time I was around them, it was some type of drama, dog. So at this time, I started hanging with my friend Adrian and Jaleel more. And Ozzy was kind of pissing me off, dog. Like, anything that she would say, he would believe. But that happens when that's your first girlfriend, you know? Fast forward, right? I get to BCC. Now, this is a new school. I'm now in college, like a fresh start. Like, I got away from high school / secondary school. So this is the first week of school. I was at this board with Jude looking to see which class we would be in. I remember there was these two girls behind us. Both of these girls look cute. So I'm there plotting, how am I gonna turn around and talk to these two cute girls behind me, right? But then Jude did that for me. She turned around, she started talking to these girls, right? So I was like, yo, this is my way in. This is my best friend talking to these girls. I'ma just turn over here and talk to them. And that's what I did, right? But then I left them because I was like, yo, I'ma just let them talk. I got some other friends to see. This is gonna be important later on in this story. So at this time, he had Larry orientation, right? And I see Jude and these two girls walking, right? And I was expecting, because there was like 3 seats next to me, I'm expecting that my best friend and these girls are gonna sit with me. These girls walk past me, dog. I'm like, okay. And then later that week, right, I see these same two girls sitting by themselves on this bench, right? And I go and try to talk to them and I get this weird vibe, dog. It was like a, yo, don't speak to me vibe. So I was like, okay, that's cool. I always blame myself for everything. So I blamed myself for that. I was like, yo, I probably said something bad the first time we talked. So then I started talking to this girl who is now my best friend. And at this time, too, I think after like a few weeks, I told Gabby I had a little crush on her. And of course, at this point in time, I am just a guy that likes her. Jude is actually a friend. And we know how it goes. Jude is a friend. So of course, Jude is gonna be closer to her than me. At this time, Jude was still dating Ozzy, and it was a mess of a relationship. They were always arguing, right? But then I remember this one day, they had a heated argument in front of the whole group, dog. Where we used to hang out, it was a heated argument. They were going at it, dog, and Ozzy stormed off, and Jude went on like this little step, and she just started bawling her eyes out. So me, being her best friend at this time, because I still had that title, I go to where she is sitting down, right? And I literally go and I try to comfort her, because that's what best friends do. And I literally get home, right? And Gabby literally has blocked me and left all the group chats that I am in. So I am hella confused, man. So I finally get through to Gabby and we agreed to come and sit down and talk about this whole thing, right? And at this time I didn't hear her because I was just a guy who was trying to talk to her. So I meet Gabby at school, and guess what Gabby is gonna tell me? My girl is gonna tell me, right, that Jude said while she was sitting there crying, right, that I was telling her that she should leave Ozzy for me, that if she was my girlfriend, none of this would never happen and all that stuff, dog. She told her that I was trying to chore chat at her while she was bawling her eyes out. First she lied to Ozzy for 2 years about me trying to still get with her, right? And now she's lying to a whole new person who I just trying to talk to. If you my best friend, why can you make me look bad to a girl that I trying to talk to? It don't make sense. So you remember those girls, right, that I talked about when I first came to BCC? Now one of those girls had actually become pretty close with the group of friends that I had at that time, especially with Gabby, all right? So one day I see her sitting on this bench by herself, and Jude is on the other bench, 2 benches down, right? And at this point in time, Jude and Ozzy had broken up. So then I was like, yo, were you not sitting
thing with your friend Jude. She's like, yo, Doug, I am not her friend. She is filled with too much drama. She's always bringing drama and problems everywhere she go. Like, I cannot exist around her. And then she looks at me and says, I don't understand how you can be friends with her either when she talks so much crap about you. I was like, what? Do tell. She's gonna look at me and say, you remember the first day I met you? The first day of BCC, when we were looking at that board trying to find our classes? She looked at us and she said that you have been trying to take her away from her best friend for years and you are in love with her and it is so gross. I was so pissed off, dog, because at this time, like I said, I've been over those feelings for years now, dog, and I've literally just been trying to just reinvent myself and be the best Tyquan that I can be at this new school, right? And you mean to tell me the first day of BCC, this girl is gonna tell these people this about me? So the last conversation we had, right? Me and my friends, we went to the beach for New Year's, right? And the next day, I get these messages from her. She's accusing Ozzy of cheating on her. And at this time, right, I thought they were still together. But apparently, no. They had actually broken up since October. And she was messaging me about this in December, dog. And she was telling me, like, yo, how can you allow him to cheat on me? Like, me and you were supposed to be brother and sister. We were supposed to be best friends. After she said all that, right, I was like, oh, that's pretty interesting. I don't think, right, I can be your brother, I can be your best friend if you're talking all that shit about me. So then I literally told her everything that I have heard, everything for the past few years, dog. And this girl literally denied everything, dog. This girl literally swore to God that she didn't say any of it. I don't think that all of these people can be wrong about the same thing, dog. Because all the stories were the same. And this girl was spreading rumors about me for like 4 years, dog. And I was just trying to exist. And I kept forgiving her over and over again. But like, that was a last straw, dog. Hey guys, what is up? My name is Tyquan and I hope you're having a wonderful day wherever you are. Thank you all for watching this video today. Hope you guys had a wonderful time watching this video. It was a long one, so I hope you guys sticked around, because it's a pretty long story, you know. This person isn't in my life anymore, but like, I don't hold any animosity towards them because I've forgiven them. If you've enjoyed what you saw on this channel, make sure to like, subscribe, share, and tell a friend. Make sure to turn on my post notifications so you'll be notified every single time that I, Tyquan Neblett, post a video. My name is Tyquan Neblett, and I hope you're having a wonderful day wherever you are. And as always, stay awesome, stay weird. Learn to cut people off and see ya.
It says do or die. Burning bridges, cutting ties to cross that whip on in the sky.